What's up guys, Section and welcome back to my channel. I hope you all have an amazing day because I am. WWDC 2019 just ended and it was hands down the best worldwide developer conference Apple ever hosted. It was just so good. There's so much to talk about. So relax, take your seat, get something to eat, drink. Obviously this video is not going to be long. This is covering every single thing that happened, everything that got announced, and I will be later making every single particular video. So particular video on macOS, iOS, in-depth video, so you know exactly what's coming. So this video is what's happening, what got announced, and let's just get started. So starting off with watchOS, it is watchOS 6, and we have some more watch faces with more complication options, so we can actually customize watch faces. Now going forward, we have taptic chimes with bird sounds. Yes, I'm reading off what I've taken on my notes. There's so much I just can memorize. So basically, they're taptic chimes with actual bird sounds, voice memos, and calculator. Finally, the calculator app is a default app on the Apple Watch. It's there. There's its own app store now. The watch does not need a phone to be installed, to install an app or something. Obviously, you still have that there, but the watch can be standalone. It connects to radio stations. You can actually ask Siri to play a specific radio with over 100,000 radio stations all around the world. So now to iOS, it is called iOS 13. So starting off, we get 30% faster unlocking speed. So whether your Face ID, you unlock, you look at your phone, it's 30% faster with 50% less space that downloading an app takes, and 60% less space and updating an app takes. So let's just say you want to update an app but you don't have that much space. Well, with now file size of those apps being 60% and 50% less, you should just be able to update that app. Going forward, 2x faster app launching speed, and finally, this been in rumors everywhere, everyone wanted this, dark mode. Now with dark mode, you get a new wallpaper, so not a light wallpaper, it's actually a dark wallpaper. All the apps within the iOS gets a new look, new refined look with matching with the dark theme. And a new thing that came to keyboard was you can actually swipe to type. You don't actually have to type every single alphabet, you can just swipe your hand, just like in some Android devices, some Android versions, you can just swipe your finger and it will type for you. I mean, not type for you, but it will just, you don't have to lift your finger, you just do the whole thing and just comes up. So now we also get a new look to the Photos app with more features of editing a photo, like exposure. We get all those new controls, and specifically we get video controls, which should have been there before, it was not, but now you can rotate a video. Let's just say you want to film a video, but then you just film it accidentally like this, you want it like this, you can actually rotate a video, crop in a video, and all that kind of stuff in the Photos app. Obviously, there's way more stuff that came into the Photos app, more details that I'm not talking in this video, but check out my other video for coming videos for this, all those details. Moving on with Music app, it got a slight update with now, let's just say you're playing a song, you actually get a synced up time lyrics, so you don't know the lyrics of a song, that's fine, it will actually be on the top in the music player, so you can actually see the lyrics, or if you want to sing along with it, you can actually sing along. Moving forward, Safari actually gets an upgrade with the text information. So let's just say your text look doesn't look nice, you get way more customization on the text side. And one really cool thing is fonts. Now you can actually have custom fonts, you can download fonts, different types of fonts onto your iOS device. With Safari, mail apps also get an improvement in actually downloading or viewing your emails. It will be much more optimized, it won't really be off-centered, it will be much more like a desktop class experience. Now, a big thing that came to iOS is the Reminders app, completely redesigned from the bottom up. You will just be able to type the way you like with some special tab all on top of the keyboard, so you don't have to be like, oh, where's that option, open that eye and do all that kind of stuff. Now, another feature, really cool feature that is in Reminders app is tagging. Now, let's just say I'm writing a reminder for me to call someone. Now, if I'm actually texting with that person, the reminder is already created. The reminder will pop up that I actually have a reminder to call that person or send something to that person. So the reminders will actually be knowing what you want. You can actually tag people and that will actually remind you. And all that other cool stuff which I will be going later in detail. Not everyone actually liked the Apple app, so the Apple Maps app, so that also got a redesign from scratch up with a really nice binocular view, or more like a 360 view. So let's just say the map is different first of all, so when you open or just you zoom out, it's different from before and after, before iOS 12 and now iOS 13. But now actually, if you search up a location, you can click on the binocular icon on the top right corner and it will take you to the street view. Or if you put your phone in landscape, you can actually 3D touch and move with the road or the flow, and making that really the coolest live street view app I've seen. So the next part with iOS is all about privacy, security, and safety, and even tracking. So let's just say you download an app and it requests you to assess your location, and you allow that. Once you allow that, that app does not ask you again and it will just use the location. Now with iOS 13, that app will actually, every time it wants to use the location, it will have to ask you. And if you do end up giving that location that you want to share your location with that app. Apple with iOS, you can actually see exactly what your location is being used for, how, where it's traveling other than the app, and you will be able to see all that detail. Now, another thing that comes in tracking or knowing your location is sign in with Google, sign in with Facebook. You know how you go on a website and you want to sign up for an account, but there's an option, sign in with Google, sign in with Facebook. So that's something that can actually be a privacy breach info, like your information can be used somewhere else. But Apple actually did a really awesome thing with security and privacy with this. They brought their own sign in with Apple. And what's specific about this, what's the cool stuff about this is you can say sign in with Apple and none of your private information, your name, your emails, your phone numbers, nothing goes to that company or the website you sign up for. Obviously, now if they request a name or request an email, Apple will give you a pop-up. What do you want? Do you want to share it? You can share it and your email name will go. Or you can actually be like, don't share it. And what Apple will do, Apple will create a fake email ID, fake information to send to that person, and as long as you want, that information is there, it's not going anywhere. So that way your real information, your real emails is not going anywhere. So I'm going to be a bit faster, not giving you as many details just because I don't want the video to be longer. So after that we have messages. Now let's just say I'm texting someone and they text me back. We have a name saved, but we don't have that picture, right? Because I mean, who will ask? So what you can actually do, you can set, for me, I can set my picture as my profile picture, or I can have a Bitmoji icon right up on the messages app, so that whoever I'm talking to, my image is already there, so they will know who I am, even with my name. Now saying that, let's just say you don't have those new phones with a face ID, so you cannot create your Bitmojis. Apple is actually putting this out for all the devices which can run A9 chips or above. There will actually be an emoji editor which you can use to create your Bitmoji, Animoji, Memoji, and have that as an icon. So you don't really need those phones or iPads with face ID sensors to create that in-depth emoji. Going forward, there's lots of updates to the camera app with new portrait mode lights and all that kind of stuff. Again, rotating a video. And then we come to Siri. Now let's just say you have AirPods and someone texts you. You hear the notification, but you don't know what that is. Well, Siri will actually speak for the notification. So let's just say someone texts me, hey, how are you? And I'm working out, I'm running. Siri will actually say a message from this person saying, hey, how are you? And I can say on the time, real time, reply this. So I don't even say, so I will just say, hey, I am good, while I'm hitting that thing, and Siri will actually send that. So that's a really good way of communicating if you don't want to take your phone out and just do quick replies. Now this does not only work with messages app, it works with third-party apps, so WhatsApp, Messenger, Instagram, all those stuff, it should work. Another thing, really cool thing, is music sharing or stream sharing. So let's just say I'm listening to music and my friend comes along. We both want to listen to the same music at the same time I'm listening to. Well, it's really simple. I will open my media player or the music player and just tap my phone onto his phone, and we both will be synced up perfectly with the music. And the same thing goes with hands off for HomePod. So let's just say I'm listening to music, I walk into my house, and now I'm like, I'm going to listen to this music on my HomePod or just out loud. I don't want to in my AirPods or my phone. Well, while I'm listening, all I have to do is bring my phone near to the HomePod, and seamlessly, a really smooth transition, it will switch to the HomePod without any breaks. So I will not even miss a single beat. Then there was an update to CarPlay, the CarPlay dashboard. So right now, if you ask Siri something, it uses different words, different phrases from different actors who have spoken those words to create a sentence. But now they're starting something called neural text to speech. With this way, every Siri command you hear, anything that Siri says, it created completely 100% by software. And they actually did a really nice demo. I couldn't get the audio right now, so what I will do, I might be able to show you on this video. So if you see it, awesome, that's how it looks. But if you don't, that's, I will be making a new video just on that, so just keep an eye on that. But basically, if you listen to Siri, it looks like a real person is talking and not a computer. Some really cool features that Apple didn't really mention, like silent unknown callers or send unknown callers directly to voicemail, all that kind of stuff. Again, everything comes in iOS 13. Moving on to iPads. Now, everything that I mentioned in iOS 13 so far is coming to iPads, but they're going to change it up. Now, iPads are not running on iOS. It's iOS, it's just for phones. iPad, they introduced a brand new operating system. It's called iPad OS, and I'm so excited to talk all about it. Now, with the iPad OS, what really happened is grid is smaller, so you can fit more icons, and a really cool thing, you can stick widgets to the screen. So you obviously have the two multitasking windows. You can have a hovering window of messages, and then you dismiss it. Let's say you want to bring Safari out, but now you're going to go back to messages. There should be easier way, right? Well, you can just flick to the left or right from the bottom. It will bring the other app, or you can just swipe up a bit and it will open Express Launcher, which is showing all the sidebar apps that I have. There's so much with multitasking Apple enabled, being able to transfer notes, being able to open two notes at the same time, two Word documents at the same time as a split screen. It's so cool. Again, I will be talking all about that in detail in a later video. Moving forward, the second biggest update to the iPads or iPad OS is Files app. Now there's a column view so you can actually see all your files or your media with a preview and quick action bars right in the Files app. You can now actually connect a USB, a thumb drive onto your iPad, a camera to an iPad, and you will see it in the Files app. Right now, without iOS 13, your chip will have another app, another software to run those things. You won't have to. Now, other stuff that came to iPads is brand new Safari. Now, Safari is fully integrated, is a desktop class browser. You don't get the tablet feature. Obviously, everything will be scaled down and optimized for the iPad resolution. But now you can actually open Google Docs, Weebly, Wix, all this stuff on Safari without having to worry about it's not going to look good, I can't do something. So whatever Safari you see on a desktop or a MacBook Pro is exactly what you will see on your iPad. So that's something we no one expected, that Apple is going to do, make Safari a full-on desktop class application. But amazing, it's amazing. Like, I'm so happy about that. Moving forward, again, custom fonts to iPad and also text editing. There's so many new shortcuts, so many new gestures you can do to undo system-wide. So instead of right now, the few shortcuts to undo, you have to shake your iPad. Well, you do a three-finger flick to undo, three-finger flick to redo, all that kind of shortcuts, including copy, paste, and cut. And lastly, the best thing that happened to the iPad with the Apple Pencil is you can take an Apple Pencil, you go from any side, any corner of the screen, and you just swipe up and it will take a screenshot of the page and it will open the annotations. Right now, the biggest problem with Apple Pencil is being able to edit and annotate stuff because you don't have that much features. So right now, let's just say I want to do something and Props gives me that UI at the bottom. What do I want to pick? I cannot move the UI anywhere. So with iOS 10, you can move the UI anywhere. You can scale it down. There's so many more things and I'm so excited to use them. So actually get hands-on with iOS 7. That's all with iPad OS. Really looking forward to it. And let's now go to Mac. Before actually getting the Mac OS out, they released two new products, so unexpected, but also expected. A brand new Mac Pro. And honestly, after looking at all the configurations of hardware possibilities, I can say personally, this is the best, the most powerful Mac ever made, a Mac Pro ever made. And going along with that, a beautiful 6K high definition, so HDR Retina monitor. So amazing, I just can't say it. It's like, you really need to see it in person, read those specs and use it. It's just so amazing that I'm actually going to make a full-on video about these two products, so I'm not going to talk much about it. So now going back on Mac OS, it was Mojave before, and everyone thought the name would be regarding or related to the California mountains. But well, Apple, it's more like a trick they did. It's under the sea or California Sea, and the name is Mac OS Catalina. Catalina, I think that's how I'm writing, say. And there's so much going on to this. Number one, iTunes is gone. iTunes is getting replaced with Apple Music. And there are two more new apps coming, Apple TV and Apple Podcasts, dedicated with specific features and all that kind of stuff onto macOS. One so amazing feature, not everyone talked about it. I talked about it in my last video about rumors or what to expect, is Sidecar. Obviously, no one knew the name. With Sidecar, what I can do, I can take my iPad. I have a MacBook. Let's just say I'm on my desk, I'm working with an external monitor. What if I'm going away, I need that monitor? I can legit use my iPad as an external screen wirelessly, no connection enabled, and also use the Apple Pencil or touch using Photoshop or anything on my iPad. So that's the best thing Apple could have brought to the Mac. Being able to use my iOS device, my iPad as an external monitor, and they went a step further by using the Apple Pencil and touch interface. It's so amazing and I actually really can't wait to try that out. Now going forward, there were lots of new things that they introduced. Specifically, something that I really like is called Find My. Now there is a Find My iPhone, Find My Friends, right? So they pretty much combined all that. But if you know, Find My iPhone only works if your device is connected to internet or connected to the connection, like the iCloud servers. What if it's not? Specifically with MacBooks, you cannot just connect them to Wi-Fi. You close them out, someone takes it. You cannot really know where they are, right? It will only show the last scene. But not anymore, because Apple is actually enabling something called Secure Bluetooth Beacon. Let's just say someone's MacBook Pro or MacBook just gets lost, and because it's not connected to the internet, it's closed, you cannot track it. But now what the device will actually be doing is it will be releasing a really small pulse that other Apple devices around it can pick up. Using Bluetooth, it won't really cost any energy, so the battery won't die or anything like that. And it will be using all those small picking points to send the current location of that MacBook Pro onto the server, so you can actually know where your MacBook Pro is. So now it does not matter if your computer is off, you are connected to Wi-Fi, cellular, you can still know where your MacBook is, even if it's lost, with all this feature. So that just went straight into what Apple's saying. You can actually locate your devices even when it's offline. Now, another thing that went right with that thieves or your MacBook or device getting stolen is activation lock. Now let's just say your device gets stolen or something, you lose it. If a MacBook or iMac has a T2 chip on it, like the new MacBooks actually have T2 chip, for them the MacBook Pro or MacBook, it's a useless piece of just aluminum, because nothing with the T2 chip and activation lock, they will just not be able to access anything. It will be just nothing to them. So that's really, again, a nice feature. No one can actually use it, no one can format it, nothing like that. Moving forward, updating Safari's view, having a much more nice, welcoming view, bringing screen time to Mac so you can actually see how much Mac you use, which software you use. To end this video off, Project Catalyst. Now, this is something I got so excited for when they started talking, like excited than the Mac Pro and everything, is Project Catalyst. Sure, they had released it before, but now really seeing that in action was just amazing. Launching 3 new kits, augmented reality and all that kind of stuff, Swift UI, just mind-blowing. I don't have any words to say this. If I start talking about it, it will be so much for this video. So one thing I'm going to really show a demo of, that demo that Apple did, was Minecraft. So Minecraft is back, coming back onto the iPad with augmented reality, and you can really use live stages, live platforms, live environment to create a Minecraft world. Then you can actually go into that world. It's just amazing. There's no words to really describe it other than what you can look in the footage. So thanks for watching. I will be making videos on every single element that came out in WWDC 2019. Once again, this was the best worldwide developer conference Apple has ever hosted. It was so exciting, specifically the developer part of it. Swift UI, I'm so in love with it. I just can't wait to get my hands on it, start using it. I will be making videos on iOS, macOS, watchOS, and all that kind of stuff. So stay tuned, press the subscribe button, the bell notification, that way you get notified. Follow me on Instagram or Twitter, because every time a video comes out, I will be posting up there, and also you will get notifications. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, please make sure to press the like button. If you have any questions, comment, just feel free to leave them below, and I will see you in the next video.